it's a lot of benefits for media-rich Silverlight applications. Now, you still need to host your HTML pages, but the Silverlight streaming service is taking care of a lot of the scalability challenges of running these media-rich Silverlight applications. So, from a developer perspective, what are the types of things you need to think about when building or using a Silverlight application, Silverlight streaming application? The first step is setting some form of application that can be hosted by the Silverlight streaming service. Now, you do this by writing a Silverlight application, and there are many sessions here that are going to talk about Silverlight, the programming model. And you take that Silverlight application and it needs to conform to some specific programming and packaging conventions. Very easy to follow, small number of steps that you need to do. You also need to provide a manifest that's going to describe that application to the hosting service. So once you have that application, you need to upload it to our Silverlight streaming service. And you can do this in one of two ways. You can either go manually to the administration site and upload the application, or you can use a REST API that we provide for you to be able to do that programmatically. Once you're hosting that Silverlight application, now you can use that hosted application from other web pages. And the way you do that, there are three simple steps that you do in order to be able to reference a couple of scripting objects in order to create some sort of element to host the application in order to instantiate it. We're actually going to take a look at a couple of these steps right now. So the first thing I wanted to show you, I'm actually going to begin backwards, and I'm going to show you a web page that is hosting a Silverlight streaming application. In fact, it wasn't even a web page that was built for this demo. It happens to be an entry on the IE team blog. So if you go to the IE team blog up on MSN, on blogs.msn.com, you'll see that in one of their entries, they're posting this little video clip. And this video clip here, I'll just play, I'm sure you've probably seen this before. I'm not hearing any audio, but I'm sure you may have seen Stephen Ballmer and his rant of developers. This is not an ActiveX control. It's not Windows Media Player. It is a Silverlight streaming application.